Good morning, students. In today's lecture of Matplotlib, I would like to discuss related to scatter plot. First of all, open Google Colab. Then click on New Notebook. You can save the content. Suppose I am writing here scatter SC. To start with the plotting content, I have to write from matplotlib import pyplot as plt. This one is the basic requirement to start with the matplotlib. After that, suppose my target is to compare admissions in different courses. In successive years, suppose my target is this one. First of all, let the variable is x. I am indicating some years 2016, 2017, 2018, 2019, and 2020. This one is the data. After that, suppose some courses are there. You can change this content into years. Then, suppose I am writing BCA. The admissions in 2016, suppose this one is 120. In 2017, this one is 78. In 2018, this one is 180. In 2019, suppose data is of 110. In 2020, data is 80. Suppose these are the values related to BCA, means these are the number of admissions in different years, in 2016, in 2017, in 2018, 2019, and 2020. Similarly, suppose I am taking the case of BCom. The admission in BCom is suppose 200, and in second year suppose admission is only 50, and in third year suppose again the equation is 100, and again this equation is 210, and this one is suppose 100. Suppose this one is the data. You can alter the data according to your choice, or whatever the content are there inside your platform or inside your campus, you can alter that content. If I am talking about CSC, suppose the admission is 170, and after that suppose admissions are 120 in second year, then in third year equation are only suppose 50, and in fourth year again admissions are suppose 300, and next time 2020 some drop down may be there, the admissions are 200. Suppose this one is the data. Suppose I have to design the graph now. PLT dot, what I have to write? Scatter. Because I have to design scatter plot, I can write scatter here. Then years, After that, suppose I have to design the graph of BCA. Okay. Only BCA content is required, suppose. PLT dot scatter is BCA. Okay. I have to execute all the contents starting from this point. First one, then after that second one, execution is required. Basically after that you can execute the content. BCA, then BCOM, and then CSC. And now suppose I am executing this one, you can display the content. 2016, then 2017, 2018, 2019, and 2020. These are the contents. This one is the admission figure. Accordingly, you can display whatever the data is there on the screen. Suppose I have to increase the size of this one. All the data is there. First one is S. Suppose I am writing S is equal to 200. It means I can increase the size of this spotted value. You can also change the design by writing marker. Suppose I am writing marker here. Marker is equal to, suppose I am writing inside star. Now again execute the program. You can indicate the data with the help of stars. You can change the color also. Suppose I am writing color is equal to green. You can change the color of stars. This one is the color of star. Okay. After entering this data, suppose I have to display the second part also. Then what I have to do, just copy this content and again paste in the next line, then again paste in the next line, because three contents are required basically. First one is BCA, third one is BCOM, second one is BCOM, and third one is CSE. This content is there. And change the marker design also. Here, suppose I am inserting circle, and here, suppose diamond is there. Suppose I am changing the color red, blue, and green. Suppose these three colors are there. Now execute the program again. You can simultaneously display all the contents. Now one more content is required in this scatter plot. Suppose I have to indicate the values differently. Then what I have to do? Suppose I am writing here title. Is equal to, in single quote, the first content is BCA. Okay. Similarly, suppose I am writing here. Let's execute first of all so that we can check whether this content is okay or not. This content is not okay. Title is not okay. Okay, suppose I am writing legend, only legend here. Okay. Just write legend here, plt dot legend, plt dot legend, yes, this one is required. What about the first data? First requirement is suppose BCA, and second requirement is BCOM, and third one is CSE. This one is required. Now execute the program. Okay, look at this one. You can check the data here. You can increase or decrease the size. Suppose I am writing only 100 here in place of CSE so that I can observe the data. Now execute this one. You can see some small size is there. If I am writing 150 here in place of 200, suppose I am writing 150, you can reduce the size of blue circle. Yes, this one is there. Now star indicate BCA, and circle, blue circle indicate BCOM, and This one is CSE. One more thing you can do, you can write the titles also. If I am writing PLT dot title, inside bracket, suppose I am writing admissions. Now look at the change. You observe the change in the top of the diagram, admissions. And similarly, I can insert X label and Y label. PLT dot X label. Inside bracket, suppose I am writing years. Similarly, PLT dot Y label. I can write here number of admissions. Number of admissions. Now execute the program. You will observe the labels also. Years, number of admissions, and admissions. This one is the admission criteria or comparison of admissions in different courses. You can display the content. Now, one thing more you can do. You can change the size of this block also. For that, what we have to do? Okay. Suppose I am writing here. Here. Suppose. Okay. What we have to do if I have to increase the size? I have to write here PLT dot figure. Okay, and then figure and inside bracket whatever the size I would like to change. Suppose I am writing here 9,7. What is the meaning of 9,7 now? 9,7 stands for 9 is length and 7 is height. Okay, let's execute this one. Okay, some error is there. I have to implement this content figure. I think this one is figure size. Okay, figure size. Yes, this content is there. Now execute the program. Yes, you can increase the figure size here. This one is the increment in size 9 into 6. Whatever 9 into 7, whatever the size you would like to change, you can change. Now execute it. You will observe 9 into 6 size is there, 9 into 6. And one more thing you can apply, you can change the background color of this scatter plot also. For that, what you can do, you can write here one variable, okay, AX. Is equal to PLT dot axis. Okay, this one is required. First of all, you have to set the axis, and after setting of axis, one more content is required. You have to change the background color because this extension is there inside figure or PLT dot axis. AX dot, what we have to do, we have to set, okay, face color. Yes, face color is there. You have to set face color inside bracket. Suppose I am writing black. K stands for black. Okay, execute the program now. You will observe the content here. You can change the background color. Whatever the color you would like to change, you can change. Suppose I am writing blue here, and blue is not required now here. Suppose I am writing white, and light colors are required, cyan and yellow. Suppose these three contents are there. Now execute the program. You will observe the different scenario. Yes, this content is there. Now cyan color, in place of cyan, suppose I am placing red so that we can clarify the content. the things should be visible. Okay, star, red star is for BCA, white is for BCom, and yellow is for CSE. And you can change accordingly. In place of yellow, you can place any other color like that. One more thing you can do, you can use color picker. Online you can select any color. Whatever the color is required by you, you can select, you can find out that hex code and you can apply. Okay. Suppose I am selecting this color and pick the hex code of this one and place. Okay. Suppose I am placing here this code. Now execute the program. You will observe the change here. Look at this one, CSE. This color picker, according to color picker, I can select the color. Whatever the color is selected by me, I can display. This one is the second color. Suppose this one is the second color, or any light color, this one. Suppose I am selecting this one and then pasting in place of white. Yes, suppose I am placing here, then execute the program again. You will observe the color here. This one is the color, this one is the second color. In place of red, suppose I am selecting some other color. Okay, suppose this color is there. Now copy this one and paste here in place of red. Using a sky code or hex value, you can change the colors also. Look at this one, you can change the color. Okay, next color, this one is the color basically. Okay, this one is the color. Copy this one and paste in place of red. This one. Now execute the program. Okay, this one is there for BCA. Whatever the color you would like to change, you can change. One more thing you can do, you can save this diagram also. Save image. Suppose I am saving on desktop. This one is scatter plot. Now save the file. You can represent this diagram to the students in enlarged view. This one is the content. You can explain the students after designing this one. 2016, this one is the admission process, and 2017, this one is the count of admissions, and 2018, 2019 and 2020, this one is the content, and star represent BCA, and this circle represent BCom, and diamond represent CSE. Hope you are enjoying the video. In the next video, I will discuss some more contents related to scatter plot.